think I'm getting land sick. I haven't caught a fish in 2 days. It feels like I'm falling apart.
Could you please describe what you see in the following images for me?
That's a snapper.
And this?
That's a bass. Looks like a can of Eidos. That's a kawai. That's a mercury burrato. It looks like a Stabycraft 2400.
Okay, Nicky. Try this Eidos adhesive. This will help you hold it all together.
Eidos, proud sponsors of Eidos Addicted to Fishing.
Nicky Sinden is addicted to fishing. Whether it's stray lining for big snapper, jigging for kingfish, spear fishing or diving, she loves it all and is on a constant quest to learn more. Join her each week as she road trips around the country, tracking down New Zealand's local fishing legends as they share their stories, tapping into their local knowledge and showcasing their tips, tricks and techniques.
Addicted to fishing. Broadbill swordfish are in a league of their own and they represent the ultimate sports fish for anglers. They are an elusive predator that can be tricky to find and hard to keep on the hook due to their notoriously soft mouths. The fights are normally long and tough with a high incident rate of heartbreaking losses at the side of the boat due to the hook pulling while the fish fights for its life. This week, I'm headed out on the water in my boat, just with my cameraman and a deckhand. And I'm keen to battle a gladiator of the ocean. But we'll see what happens.
Broadbill swordfishing is one of the most highly regarded big game species in the ocean, even though they have been caught by relatively few anglers. Any rod and reel catch is a notable distinction regardless of size, although the average catch well exceeds 80 kilos, with the world record sitting at a whopping 536 kilos.
So we've actually got up at 3 a.m, hit the water by 4:30, and we've just come out here. We're on the 100 metre mark, and I can see a whole heap of bait on the sounder here, so that's a really good sign already, because what we're trying to do is catch some fresh skippies, because as you know, with swords, fresh is best. So it seems that skippies are a lot like 10-year-old girls because they like to go for the pink colour.
Swordfish feed daily, most often at night. They swim to the surface in search of smaller fish and they use their sword to slash and stun their prey. We're trolling for skippies as they are the freshest bait that we can find on our way out to the spot.
Here we go. It is a beautiful looking bait, if I've ever seen one. Hardly even had the skippy lures in the water for long. Bam! They tend to go a bit crazy. Okay, so we just put them in the tuna sheds just for now, just to keep them in there. We haven't actually got the water on, just a holding device at the moment. We're going to wrap them up in glad wrap soon to try and keep them nice and fresh, and then we're going to put them on ice. The fresher the baits, the better when it comes to sword fishing. Alright, well we've got 6 fresh skippies, so I think we'll be all good for fresh bait. We do have a few squid and we've got a few other bits and pieces in my little bag of tricks to try and get these swords. But what we're going to do next is rig up a few of these skippies, head out to the spot and then start to drop them down. We all like to have a nice fresh lunch, and swords are no different. So what I'm doing is I'm going to pack a swords lunch. We've just got these skippies and we're going to wrap it with blade wrap to try and keep the gut cavity and everything intact beautifully. And we're going to put it on ice. Okay, now we've got our baits for later. The next two I'm going to rig up. Alright, so what we've done is I've just used a bit of wax string and I've just sort of stitched through the face and the gills. We want those gills to be nice and closed to minimise drag, and we don't want it to be spinning around on the way down. Used a bit more wax string, and I've just tied my wax string onto the 18 barrow circle hook. Hopefully get a perfect lip hook with that one. Okay, so it's sort of 1 to 2 knot drift today, which is great. Great for sword fishing. So we're just gonna very carefully drip feed this back. We don't want any tangles. Over goes our glow stick. Now our wind on leader. We're just gonna guide it until we get to our loop. So what I've done here is I've made a bit of a loop in our wind on leader using the wax string and some 4 kilo line. And that's how we're gonna attach our weight. So obviously we need a bit of weight to get it all the way down to 350 meters. So attach onto our 4 kilo line, homemade weights that I made at home yesterday. Right, so I'm just feeding that down. We're just using mono today. A lot of people like to use Dacron, not a problem with that, but personal preference, we're using mono. Now that sun's come up, it's heating up. It's heating up nicely. So I'm just keeping a really good eye on the end of the rod tip there. Basically, if we see any kind of slack or like a belly in the line, then we know that we're going to be hooked up. You don't normally hear a lot when you hook up to a sword. It's the kind of thing where, you know, in your mind, you probably think, well, it's such a big, powerful, heavy, fast fish that you'd hear the line scream off, but you don't. Certainly a patience thing. You just got to watch that line.
Swordfish are unique as they can change their body temperature to accommodate for the varying water temperatures at different depths. It's because of this that they can feed at all levels of the water column during both the day and the night.
We've got all the ingredients for success. We've had the baits, we've got the weather, the current's not too strong, and we've got the marks and the sounder. So, fingers crossed. There he is, I can see him. It's a sword, and it's not a small one.
Stay tuned to see how some more of the swordfishing action unfolds. This week on ADOS Addicted to Fishing, my mission is to come face to face with a broadbill swordfish. With me is my cameraman and a deckhand to help. We've got a fresh bait soaking and the Tiagra has just started ticking.
Start to tick out, and we've just knocked it up a couple of clicks. We're going to be really patient with it. We don't want to lose this fish. Yeah, there's lots of weight there. Let's go. Come on. Bring it on, Mr. Sword. Yeah, baby, it's a sword. Okay, so he's going down, he's going for a big deep dive. So I'm just gonna sit back on him and really put the pressure on him. Takes pressure off me, and it's putting a bit of tension on him, He'll come back up soon, but check out the bend in that rod. We've got nearly 13 kilos of drag on him. Hoo-hoo. He's got issues. This fish has issues. Okay, so we've just bumped the drag up over strike, so we're now sitting at 15 kilos and he is still peeling me. Whew, he is not happy.
Ready?
Yep. We're sort of driving our sword away very slowly into the middle of nowhere so we can have this fight all on our own. Oh, he's peeling. Whatever I do, I'm just gonna make sure that I stay relaxed and calm and winding every chance that I get because could be here for a while. But this isn't solid. Yeah, baby. Come on.
Yeah, it is.
Oh my god. Okay, so we finally got it to this, up to the surface. As you can see out there, it's a sword, and it's not a small one. We just radioed in to some friends of ours to quickly come over and jump on board and help us gaff it because I don't know if I can do this one on my own. This is what it's all about. This is so exciting. Here's our mates arriving. Here we go. This is it, guys. Thanks, Luke.
We're gonna go forward, Luke. Come on, man.
Okay, get ready. Hey, mate, I'm Nicky.
Hey.
Hey. Okay, we've got this, guys. We've got this.
Just spread them out, mate. No slack line, no slack line.
And just like that, the hook pulled.
So we've hit the water again this morning. Yesterday was unbelievable. I think that maybe I need another crew member, so we've got Jed's old man out with us today, Paul. And so we've got two people on the leader / boatman. I'll be on the rod, and let's hope that we can actually tackle one of these ultimate fish. I'm excited, I'm not gonna lie. So we just deployed our first bait for the day. We've actually come out to the spot and the weather has jacked up a bit compared to the other day. Now, contrary to popular belief, these swords aren't the fussiest eaters. You can use a variety of different baits, such as squid, kawai, mullet, skippies. Today we've actually put a kawai down, and obviously we've got a lot stronger winds today. The wind and the current, they're not exactly working together, so it's gonna pull us along a lot quicker, but we've got the bait down there. Pretty happy with the way that we're going. You can see a little bit of bait on the sounder, and yeah, fingers crossed.
Coming up on the show, we continue with our mission and we start the battle all over again. This week, we've been fishing for Broadbill Swordfish and have already had one heartbreaking loss. We're now on a new day with an extra crew member to help, and it doesn't take long before the Tiagra starts hemorrhaging.
Right,
line, they're all coming up at the moment. Oh, nice red too. So there's fish down there worrying them, so it could be good.
We've got beautiful line angle going out the back. I'm getting as much line as I can. I can feel the weight there, but he's not going to be happy when he realises that he's hooked up. He's taking heaps of line now. He's peeling. Absolutely peeling.
Blow the peel down?
Yeah.
Can't get line, you rest, and just like you have there, have the rod bent like that, it's perfect. He's coming up and down, so that's good. He hasn't done a big run to the bottom. So we're just still getting to know each other.
Yeah.
Going for the...
This is like the second date.
Yeah. Going steady, not even going steady stage.
We haven't even started holding hands. This is like...
Oh, it's a second date, girl. Jeez. Here we go. Get all that back now. He's on the top, eh? That's the way. Keep that rod bent. I like him when he's up there. I don't like him when he's under my boat.
Yeah, baby. Let's do it.
Might see him on the top soon, eh?
This is awesome. Sword.
Coming back up again, eh?
Yeah. It's good.
Won't be long until you want to come and check out what's pulling them, eh?
Woo! I've got about 10 kilos of drag on him and he is peeling line. This could be a good fish.
Coming back now. Now he's coming up, eh? See that? Run was away from the boat and up.
We're an hour and a half into the fight and the sword has just realised that it's a sword and it is peeling me. We had only 150 metres to go. I now have probably 350, so I'm getting settled in. The boys are feeding me water and we're getting settled in for the fight. Absolutely hemorrhaging line. Right, so we've just clocked 2 hours. Finally, it's my turn to get some line back, so just using the waves as I go up the waves, winding on the way down, we go up, slow and steady, lots of patience, nowhere else I'd rather be.
Keep working again.
Okay, so this is the 3 hour mark, probably got about 100 metres left to go, seem to be gaining on him quite well, so good sign. He's we've had a look on the Bruno TZ Touch and it tells me that it's dragged us 3 nautical miles. It's about a mile an hour, so these fish are just so strong. But we're gaining on him, so
Keep winding.
I can see something.
Got colour.
Yeah, we've got colour. It's coming up. Look, he's right there.
After 3 hours and 25 minutes, the swordfish comes to the surface and it had been tail wrapped during the fight, causing it to drown due to it being pulled in backwards.
Let's be nice and gentle with them. What do you want me to do?
Nothing. You're good. You're good. Don't whine. That's all right.
Go again. Oh, my God.
Hang on, I've got a hook in my hand.
You've got a sword!
Woohoo! Yeah, here
we go. I just got a sword! Woo! Yes!
Here he is, mate. Here's your sword, ready?
3 hours. And I got him. I wanted to light up again. Yeah, baby.
Swordfish.
Wow. That was unbelievable. The power in these fish, it's just unreal. This is the ultimate fish. This is a fish of my lifetime, right here. And you just witnessed it. You just witnessed that. It is amazing. Well, this is the conclusion of season two of Eidos Addicted to Fishing. I really hope that you've enjoyed this journey. I have to say, if it wasn't for the sponsors make the show 100% possible. It's all sponsor funded, and so without them, we wouldn't be able to do this and bring you this show. Thank you to the viewers, and thank you to my crew that helped me make the show. And we're going to leave you with some highlights of season two, and we will see you again next time for season three of Eidos Addicted to Fishing. Woo! I love that moment when you just wait to see the colour. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! There's nothing else in the world that I'd rather be doing right now.
Come on, Nicky.
440 metres to go. Woohoo! Oh, beautiful, stunning fish.
Breathing going on there, Nicky.
This is a ho-hora snapper. Come to mama. And guess what we're having for dinner? That was amazing!
Woohoo!
Eidos Addicted to Fishing adventures in confidence in our Staby craft, which is powered by our Mercury Marine, and we tow it around in our Ford Ranger. Smart Marine supply us with our Shimano tackle, we find the best fishing spots with our Furuno, we celebrate our catch with a wild buck, we keep up to date with Fishing World magazine, and it all sticks together thanks to Eidos.